Right. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. So, production of food from animals. To produce food from animals, we need to protect them, give shelter to them, give food to them, all these things. Okay? We need to give food for them, protection, shelter, shelter to them, and good care should be taken for their health. All these things together is called as animal husbandry. Animal husbandry. It includes poultry also, it includes fishes also, not only animals. Okay? You can take sericulture also in this only. Even if it is bees culture, birds culture, all these cultures are a part of animal husbandry only, right? So what are there in this? Protection, shelter, care for health, and even reproduction, breeding of animals also. Breeding means crossing them and producing new babies also. All these are included in animal husbandry, right? So we'll discuss from cow. So, buffaloes, milk yielding animals. Animal husbandry is not something that is new. It was animals were domesticated even before you can say something 10,000 years before Christ also. Animals were taken care of, animals were bred. These domestication of animals was done even before 10,000 BC. Dog was domesticated, sheep was domesticated, pig, even pig and cat, goats, all these things were domesticated before several thousands of years, right? Okay, right. Milk yielding animals. So when it comes to animal breeding, most important thing is they should be provided with good food. If they are provided with good food, only yield will be good. Okay? Nowadays, instead of providing good food, they are supplementing hormones. This is a very bad option. This can ruin the health of that animals also. It can spoil the health of people who consume that products of animals also. Right? And health of that animal is also very important to keep care of proper health. The shelter should be always maintained neat. Neatness should be maintained. Temperature should be maintained. And dryness should be maintained. And always fodder should be there in the shelter. Fodder means food that is given to animals. It's called as animals. It's called as fodder. All these care should be taken. If the proper health care is not taken, sometimes animals get skin diseases. Sometimes they get worm infection in their stomach. Worm infections in their stomach. And we can see that one type of disease called head and foot disease. Mouth and foot disease. Mouth and foot disease, MFD. This is also very common. Sometimes sheep are affected with anthrax disease. Anthrax is a skin infection. So all these things affect the animals. To avoid this, they should be maintained in proper temperature, proper food should be given, and neatness should be maintained. That fodder should be removed, cleaned, everything should be cleaned timely. And moreover, animals, where there are animals, there is a lot of chance for flies and mosquitoes, because they spread off everything. If they eat anything, they spread off. If they shit, they spread off. So that should be maintained always neatly. And dryness also should be maintained. If it is wet, okay, if it is wet, if you leave, there may be chance for fungal infections also. So that is about it, children. Next. milk-yielding animals. Milk yielding animals, animals like goat, buffalo, cow are usually preferred for milk. Apart from that, sometimes donkeys, camels, sheep also is taken. Donkey, camel, sheep milk is also used in some parts. Okay, generally most of the time buffalo's milk is preferred over the cow's milk. Okay, sometimes cow's milk is considered to be more in some parts of country. Cow's milk has more preference. In some parts it is buffalo's milk. But an average buffalo gives only 2 to 5 liters of milk every day. To overcome this problem, what is done is crossing was performed between this local variety animals and foreign variety of animals, and breeds like Murra breed, and this Murra breed buffalo can it can give milk from 20 to 30 liters, no, 8 liters, I think 8 liters per day. There are certain breeds of buffaloes like Haryana, Jafarabad, Nagpuri. This type of buffaloes, they give good yield. There are some varieties from England like Jersey, Denmark breed like Holstein. They can give 25 liters of milk per day. Okay, 20 to 25 liters of milk per day. Oh, but our local variety, this Murra breed, can give 8 liters of milk per day. Right, this is a breed that is obtained by crossing of local variety with foreign variety. Local buffaloes are crossed with foreign varieties like Holstein, Jersey, and then this Murra was obtained. Okay, so this is one technique to increase the yield. What is the use of this milk? From this milk, various products like curd, cheese, ghee, butter, buttermilk, different things are obtained, right? If these animals die, their skin is also sold, their bones are also useful, their meat is also sold. So nothing goes to waste from these organisms. But the worst thing that is done is to increase the production, they are given with hormonal injections. That is a very bad thing. Hormonal injection is given to enhance the age of that buffalo, so that it starts producing at the early age, to it starts producing milk at the early age. So that is a very bad thing that is seen among this cattle. A scientist, his name is J.K. Kurian. He's famous for white revolution in India. White revolution. White revolution means increasing milk production by producing these varieties of buffaloes. He was behind this by producing hybrid buffaloes, increasing animal health. This war all was taken care, and he was called as father of white revolution. He increased all this by a process called Operation Floods. The name that is given for this hybridization of buffaloes and increasing milk production, supplying properly, collecting properly, preserving properly, pasteurization method was discovered by that time by Louis Pasteur. So using all these methods, yes, he's also Amul company chairman. Very good information from Srivardhan. Yeah. So he started this program called Operation Flood. Because of this, only milk production increased in India. Okay. So if these people contribution used not to be, every one of us used not could not get the milk like this, right? Nowadays every house at least 1 liter. Some people use 2 liters per day. That is possible. Every house is using now. Okay, that is possible. This much amount of milk production is possible because of contribution of J.K. Kurian, right? So that is it. So the first produced milk, generally we call Jinnupalu. Did you ever eat that? This is called as colostrum. Colostrum is the first milk that comes from animals. The first milk that comes is called as colostrum. This milk is rich in vitamins like vitamin A, D, E. This is rich in antibodies. The main thing that is rich in, it is rich in antibodies. Since it is rich in antibodies, it increases immunity. It is a very good source of protein. It is a very good source of minerals. Apart from that, it is a very good source of antibodies, which increases immunity. So this can be collected 72 hours after the baby's birth. Okay, why this animal secrete this is, the newly born baby will not have sufficient amount of immunity to fight with the, is not exposed to any microorganism outside environment till that time. At once he is exposed to thousands of microorganisms that are in the environment at once. So to protect that baby from the immune, pathogens that are around us, these animals secrete this colostrum. Okay, it is very good for health, for our health also. We can also use it, right? So usually our mothers make them with the with this milk. They make sweet dishes, different sweet dishes which are very delicious. You can have them. They are very good for health. Next, we'll discuss about poultry. Poultry is taking care of hens. Hens, there are breeds of hens called boilers, broilers, and layers. Broilers are those which have very good muscle buildup. So they are used for meat. They are tamed, they are domesticated for meat. Layers lay very good number of eggs, they are domesticated for eggs. Okay, apart from that, there are local varieties of local breeds which are generally called as Natukodi. Right? Okay, not only these, there are some cocks which are used for fight. Like Asil is a breed that is used for cock fights. Generally, these poultries are tamed for these different purposes. And whatever the type may be, it takes, first the eggs are laid inside the chambers called brood chambers. Then they are taken care in such a way that, emu is also a part of poultry. All those which belong to this family. There are quail birds that are tamed under this poultry only. Emu, sometimes even ostriches are tamed. And there is a specific, one specific hen called Chimakodi. I don't remember its English name. That is also a part of poultry only. All this hen family, you can include all this hen family in this only, right? So they are tamed, they are taken care in special, rooms. They are taken care that each one is separate. And most importantly, they usually do a lot of shit. That shit should not be in contact with that poultry. So in that way, the racks are arranged that all the shits go down. No, not anteater. I'll say you the name of that one. It has black dots all over the body. You ask your mother about anteater, Chimakodi. I'll show you that. Yeah, that is it. Guinea fowl is called as Chimakodi. Turkey is also part of this only. So all these are included in this poultry farming. We have different varieties like Hampshire, Plymouth, Anoka, white leg hen, white leg hen. We had Rhode Island, or some of the foreign varieties. These are all foreign varieties that give very good meat. Okay. If a wild one takes 5 to 6 weeks to grow completely, broilers grow in 6 to 8 weeks. 5 to 8 weeks for a normal hen to grow. Okay. A broiler grows in 6 to 8 weeks. While hens called layers, they lay eggs very fast and they should grow like 21 to 72 weeks should it should be grown to get eggs. And once they grow to that particular age, they can lay from 300 eggs. They can lay approximately 300 eggs around, right? So that is their growth period, right? When they lay eggs, hatching period is usually seen in November at that time. And at that time, they lay a lot of eggs, and these eggs are laid in chambers and they are allowed to hatch, incubation chambers. In that incubation chambers, a certain temperature is maintained, 37 to 38 degrees Celsius of temperature is maintained, and they are allowed to grow in that, and they hatch very fast. Something around 20-21 days it takes for hatching. After it is hatched, then they are again taken care. The small babies are taken care that they are not easily killed. Even you take the local variety hen also, they should be kept in certain basket which is full of something that can hold warmth, like a worm, straw. They can use straw to keep it warm, or they can use some husk to keep it warm. But it should be kept warm. This type of material will keep it warm. 37 to 38 degrees Celsius is required for hen to hatch. That temperature is maintained inside that chamber. In case of this local variety hen, that temperature is provided by that warmth of this body. By this way, it produces this hatches the eggs. Once the eggs are collected, they are set in the racks and they are sold in the market, right? So it is very good for health because egg is a very good source of albumin and globulin, and these are the albumin and globulin which are present in egg are actually blood proteins. They are very good for building up a very good healthy blood, which is very good. In a healthy blood is a blood which can fight with diseases very efficiently. So for that buildup, we need to eat at least one egg a day. National Egg Coordination Committee says that eating one egg per day is required for every health to be healthy for any person, right? Okay, next, emu is the fastest bird, second largest bird after ostrich. Ostrich. So after ostrich is the first largest bird, after ostrich it is the second largest bird. This is also an organism that is used for collecting meat. It lays about 50 cages of meat. It produces about 50. Once it is completely grown, it can weigh 50 cages, around 50 cages, right? So this is one of the bird that is used, that is grown for its chicks also, its meat also. Okay. Next one is apiculture. Apiculture is growing of bees. Apiculture. Apiculture means growing honeybees for the purpose of honey. Honeybees are grown for honey. There are varieties of honeybee and Apis indica. There are certain varieties. Apis serena. Right? Apis Apis indica. There are some other, I don't remember all the names right now. So these are some of the varieties that are found in what do you say, honeybees. Among this, Mellifera is European variety, which can yield up to 25 to 30 cages of 25 to 30 cages of honeybee. Okay, every year 25 to 30 cages of honeybee it can yield, right? Apis sirena can yield about 10 cages per, approximately 10 cages per year. Okay, maximum 10 cages per year. Minimum can be 3 to 4 cages per year, right? Okay, among this Apis bees, there are varieties like worker bees, drones and females. Females are leaders of the family. Females are leaders of the family and they take care of the entire like total kingdom is under their control. Okay, they do not do any work. Total work is done by worker bees, and drones' function is only mating. Once they mate, okay, once they mate, that is they give their sperm to the female, they die off, that's all, right? Their function is to participate in mating with that female only, that's all. There is no other function. Once it participates in that mating, it dies off immediately because of the bursting of its abdomen, right? And if the female's function is laying eggs, it lays 800 to 1200 eggs. Female bee lays about 800 to 1200 eggs per every day, and it can live for 2 to 3 years, right? 2 to 3 years it can live, and drones can live for about weeks, few weeks. It can live only few weeks, whereas workers live only 57 days. Drones live for 5 to 6 weeks and workers live for only 57 days. So that is about their different qualities. And once they, worker bees, they collect their honey from different places. They feed the larva. They have all the important cores that to be maintained are by honey worker bees only. Once the worker bees collect the sufficient amount of honey, that honey will be extracted very carefully. Okay, it is used only, not only honeybee, apart from honeybee, bee wax is used for making candles, nail polish, etc. And bee venom is also used. Okay, bee venom is used to make a Apis tincture. It is used in homeopathic treatments. Apis tincture is a medicine that is used in homeopathic treatments. That is obtained from bee venom, right? And construction of bee hives, there will be some brood floors on which all these baby larva will be kept, and above that there will be one more chamber, brood chamber. Above that one more super chamber will be there. All this will be closed in a there will be a frame, double frame. Inner frame will be there, outer frame will be there, and for entrance there is a small rod like structure. Okay, so in this beehive, three floors are there. First floor for brood, next brood chamber, after that one more chamber. There is a covering, first layer frame, second layer frame, rod for entrance. All these are present inside this beehive. Okay, once the beehive is completely, when it collects the nectar, honey sufficiently, then all these bees are carefully transferred from one beehive to another beehive. Okay, so these people who are dealing with this bees, Apis, those who are involved in bee culture, they know very well how to transfer these bees from one brood chamber to another brood chamber. They do not get harmed. They protect themselves by gloves and all. And they have their techniques to transfer them. Once the transfer is done, the honey is carefully extracted from that. Sometimes, sometimes there are some pests and predators that affect these chambers also. protection should be taken from that pest and predators also. That is also their job, right? That is about apiculture. Last comes fisheries. Fisheries, in fisheries, there are marine water fishery, freshwater fishery, okay? Our coastline of India is 7,200 kilometers. This 7,200 kilometers of coastline, total coastline acts as marine water fishing, right? And apart from that, 0.48 million offshore, that means which is not on the shore, just away from the shore also, some fishing is done. That area is 0.48 million square meter, right? And there are certain varieties of fishes that are obtained from marine waters like mackerel, sardines, mackerel, crustaceans. Excuse me, children. So, mollusk, catfish, ribbon fishes. These are the varieties that are obtained from marine water. And apart from this marine water fishes, we have some freshwater fishes also like katla, rohu, seal. You know about this, you have studied about this in your previous classes also. Katla, rohu, seer are the fishes which are found in freshwater. Along with this, crabs, prawns, lobsters, all these are also they are cultured in this fresh fisheries, right? And so in this also everything is important, like in case of any other animal husbandry, collection of correct amount, correct type of fish breed, taking care of their chambers, giving proper food, protecting them from diseases, these all are important for this fisheries also, right? And sometimes the brackish water fishes also are there. Brackish water means where the sea water joins with the fresh water. In that area also we can find growth of certain fishes. Okay, whatever it may be. Fishes can be even mechanical. Nowadays nets are not used for collecting the fishes. Mechanical machines are used for collecting these fishes, right? These fishes are very healthy for the healthy food, as they have a very good source of omega fatty acids. They are very good rich source of iron, vitamin E, and the oil that is present in their body is also very cod liver oil. They are called as cod means fishes. Cod liver oil, shark liver oil, they are also very good source of vitamin E. So these fishes are either eaten fresh or they are salted for future use. Okay. So that's all about these fishes. Sometimes fishes are grown in a special technique in which one layer of fishes which grow on the lower layers are added in the same tank, and next layer of fishes which are grown on the top layers. This is a special system which is called as composite fish culture system. 2-3 varieties fishes will be grown in the same water body. And care is taken that one fish that is selected is growing on the lower layer, next fish will be growing on the top layer. For example, we can say that katlas are surface feeders. Rohu is in middle zone. Mackerels and common crabs grow on the top region. These three can be collected and they can grow in the same water body. In that way, space is saved and more amount of yield can be obtained from the same project, okay? And estuaries are those areas where brackish water is there, where salt water combines with fresh water. In these areas, the fishes that grow will be, they can grow these fishes very well because they are suitable for fresh water also, salt water also. In this type of system, the yield will be more. So generally, estuaries are also chosen for this fishing purpose, right? Okay, children, with this we have completed today's topic.